Welcome to this brief guide on how to build a project timeline in Google Sheets. Do you ever feel overwhelmed just starting a project in a spreadsheet? Figuring out what columns you need, formatting everything? It's enough to make you want to give up before you even begin. But guess what? Google Sheets has an amazing feature to help you out. Pre-built table templates. These templates give you a head start with ready-made tables for all sorts of projects. And once you've got your data organized, you can easily transform it into a visual masterpiece with the brand new timeline feature. Get ready to become a project planning pro. All right, so here we are in a brand new Google Sheet. See this menu bar at the top? It's full of useful tools for working with your spreadsheets. We're going to start by clicking on the Insert menu. This opens up a drop-down menu with a whole bunch of things that we can insert into our sheet. And right here, we have Tables. Let's go ahead and click on that. Now you'll see this Tables sidebar appear on the right-hand side of your screen. This sidebar is where we can access all of those awesome pre-built templates. As you can see, there are templates for all sorts of things: event tasks, project tasks, content trackers, and more. They're even organized into categories like event planning, customer relations, and project management. This makes it super easy to find the perfect template for your needs. If you hover over a template, you'll get a preview of what it's going to look like. For our tutorial, we're going to use the project task template. Give it a click, and there you have it. A perfectly formatted table appears in our sheet, ready for us to add our project information. No more messing around with creating columns and formatting headers. The template takes care of all of that for us. Now we can start filling in our project details. And the great thing about this template is that it not only provides columns for our task names, but it also includes ready-made columns for things like start and end dates, the task owner, and even notes. I'll quickly add a couple of tasks to show how easy it is to get started. First, I'll add Write Project Proposal as our first task. Now, I can use the dropdown in the Priority column to set the priority level for this task. I'll set it to P0 since it's a high priority task. And in the Status column, I can use this dropdown to indicate that this task has not yet been started. Next, I'll add another task called Gather Project Requirements. I'll set it to priority P1 and its status to not started as well. As you can see, it's super easy to get started with this template. It provides all of the necessary columns and even includes pre-configured dropdowns to make data entry quick and efficient. Now to save time, I've prepared another sheet here with the same project task template. But this one is already filled in with data for a software development project. This is the same template that we just looked at, just with more information already added. Okay, now let's bring this project to life with the brand new timeline view. To create a timeline, we need to go up to the menu bar and click on Insert. This time, we'll select Timeline. You'll see this pop-up window appear. This is where we tell Google Sheets which data we want to use for our timeline. You'll notice that Google Sheets has already suggested a selection for us. It's smart enough to detect the table in our sheet and automatically select the relevant cells. This saves us from having to manually select the cells or type in the range. I'll click OK, and there we have it. Our project plan is now displayed on a timeline. Each of these bars represents a task from our table. The length of the bar shows how long the task is scheduled to take from its start date all the way through to its end date. This gives us a much clearer picture of how our project is structured, when each task needs to be completed, and how the different tasks overlap with each other. Now, let's say we want to change the timescale for our timeline. Maybe we want to see the tasks by week, or maybe potentially even by day. We can do that by using these controls in the top right here. We can switch between days, weeks, months, quarters, or even years. This allows us to focus on a specific part of the timeline or get a broader view of the entire project. Now, in order to customize the appearance of our timeline, we need to click on this settings button located right above the timeline. This opens up the timeline settings sidebar on the right-hand side of the screen. Here you can see the data range field, which shows the cells that are being used for our timeline. As you can see, it's already populated with the range of our table that we selected. Below that, we have the start date and end date dropdowns. These are automatically populated because Google Sheets recognize the start date and end date columns in our table. Next, we have the card title dropdown. This determines which column from our table is used to name each card on the timeline. In our case, it's using the task column, which is correct. Now, let's move down to the optional fields section. This is where we can customize the appearance of the cards on our timeline. First, we have the card color dropdown. We can use this to color code our cards based on different criteria. For example, we could color them by priority. I'll select priority from the dropdown, and now you can see that the cards are colored according to their priority level. But let's say that maybe we wanted to color them by status instead. We can simply select status from the dropdown, and now the cards are colored based on their status. The cool thing is that this is using the same colors that we have in our table. So tasks that are blocked are red, tasks that are in progress are yellow, tasks that are completed are green, and tasks that are not yet started are in blue. Next, we have the detail dropdown. This allows us to display additional information on the cards. I'll select notes, and now you can see that the notes from our table are displayed on the cards. Finally, we have the group cards by dropdown. This allows us to group the cards based on a specific column. I'll select owner, and now you'll see that the cards are grouped by who they're assigned to. This makes it super easy to see who is responsible for which tasks and how their workload is spread out over time. And you'll notice that the overarching phases from our table are now displayed at the top of the timeline. This is because they don't have any owner assigned to them, so they're treated as overarching categories. This is great for letting us see the overall status of each phase of the project. And there you have it. We've explored how to use the Google Sheets table templates to quickly set up a project plan, and then we use that timeline view to visualize our plan and make it even more powerful. And don't forget, just like any other Google Sheet, you can share your project timelines with your team to collaborate and keep everyone on the same page. And one final note, whilst the table templates are openly available, as of the time I'm making this video, the timeline view feature is only available to those with Google Workspace accounts. But don't worry, it's expected to roll out to consumer accounts in the very near future. So get out there and give it a go, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.